Jayasunetha, working as assistant professor in mechanical department. I am going to teach CAD/CAM for this semester. What are the prerequisites of CAD/CAM? Why we learn CAD/CAM? As mechanical engineers, it is important for us to learn the use of computers in design and manufacturing. That is why this subject CAD/CAM has been incorporated in our syllabus. And now let us see what are the objectives of the of this course. Okay, to provide an overview of how computers are being used in design and also in development of manufacturing plants, and also to understand the need of integration of CAD and CAM. And also, what are the course outcomes? Course of, by the end of the semester, students will be able to understand geometric transformation techniques in CAD, and also they will be able to develop mathematical models to represent curves and surfaces. And also, students will be able to model engineering components using solid model techniques. And also, they will be able to develop programs for CNC to manufacture industrial components. And also they will be understanding the applications of computers in various aspects of manufacturing. And in our syllabus we have 5 units. Unit 1, we will be learning about fundamentals of CAD and also CAM. And also we will be learning about geometric modeling, wireframe modeling and also curve fitting techniques. And in Unit 2, we will be learning about surface modeling. In that, we will be learning how to derive mathematical expressions to develop surfaces. And also, we will be learning about constructive solid geometry, boundary representation. In Unit 3, we will be learning about computer-aided manufacturing. NC control production systems, will be learning about all the elements and all the all about numerical control system and also computer assistant part programming and also how to write a manual part programming. And also we'll be learning about CNC, BNC and also adaptive control systems. In Unit 4, it is group technology. We'll be learning about part families, parts classification and coding, production flow analysis, and also computer-aided manufacturing resource planning. In that, we'll be learning about MRP, MRP inputs and outputs, and also benefits of MRP, ERP and CRP. And in Unit 5, we'll be learning about flexible manufacturing system. In that, we'll be learning about FMS equipment, layouts, analysis, methods for FMS, and also coordinate measuring machine vision, and also computer integrated manufacturing system. Today we will be learning about introduction to computer aided design and computer aided manufacturing. The contents we are going to learn are CAD/CAM, definition of CAD/CAM, the product life cycle and introduction to computer technology, computer programming languages, fundamentals of CAD, design process, application of computers for design, benefits of CAD, CAD hardware and CAD software. CAD/CAM, as you know, CAD is computer-aided design and CAM is computer-aided manufacturing. It is the technology to use digital computers to perform certain functions in design and also manufacturing. And we can also say CAD as the use of computer systems to create, modify, analyze and optimize an engineering design. And as we know, we are using computers, so let us see what is the configuration of computer system. Computer system consists of computer hardware and also computer software. This is known as configuration of computers for CAD. Now let us see what is CAM. CAM is defined as the use of computers to plan, manage and control the operations of a manufacturing plant through either direct or indirect interface with the plant's production process. We use computers directly or indirectly in the manufacturing process to plan, manage and control the operations of the manufacturing plant. And this CAM is broadly classified into two types. One is computer monitoring and control, and the second one is manufacturing support applications. Now in this figure you can see the CAM is classified into two types. One is computer monitoring and control, and the other one is manufacturing support applications. Now let us learn in detail what are the two different types of CAM. The first step is computer monitoring and control. This is known as direct application, in which we use the computers directly. The computers are connected to the manufacturing process, and the computers are used for monitoring and as well as controlling the process. Now if you see the figure here, you can understand first one is computer process monitoring and the other one is computer process control. The first one, if you observe, you can see a computer and the process. There is only one way. Okay? The computer will only process the manufacturing process. But there is no other direction. There is no connection in the reverse direction. This is only one direction. So we are calling it as computer is only monitoring the process. It can only monitor. And the second figure, if you observe, you can see a computer and a process where there you can find two arrows. There is a connection. The process data is, it is receiving from the process, and also it is sending some signals, control signals. It is a two-way process. So we can say the computer is not only monitoring, but it is also controlling. If something goes wrong, it will get the data and it will send the signal. It will correct the data and it will send the data, so and it will also control the process. This is known as computer process monitoring and also computer process monitoring and control. The second type we are seeing is indirect application, indirect use of computers in manufacturing process. That is known as manufacturing support applications. Here we are using computers, but it is not directly linked to the manufacturing process, where we use computers only for certain operations or certain functions, such as plans, to plan, to schedule and to forecast and also to instruct. Only for these operations we use computers. Okay, only manufacturing scheduling will be done, and also some instructions, if anything is required during the manufacturing process, the computer will develop such instructions and it will monitor the process. This is known as manufacturing support applications. And the next one is, in this unit we are going, the next topic we are going to learn, and the important topic is the product life cycle of CAD CAM. If you see, what is product cycle? The product cycle is nothing but the various activities and functions which are performed in a manufacturing field, manufacturing plant. It is known, that is known as product cycle. If you observe in the slide, you can see various activities plus functions is equal to product cycle. Now if you see in this figure, you can see there is a customers and market. Depending upon the need of the customer, they will develop a product, concept is developed. And after that, it will be sent to the design department, where the engineers will design and develop the drawings. Now if you see the next one, drafting. The drafting is made. The drawings are being made as per the given design. And also after the drawings are prepared, that will be sent to the manufacturing plant, where they will do, first they will do the process planning. Okay, The process planning will be done, and also they will see whether any new equipment or tooling is required to develop that particular component. And also they will send the, after the process planning is being done by the engineers, it will be sent to the production scheduling, where they will see which operation has to be performed on which time. It has, the scheduling will be done for each, operation, each operation of the component will be developed, and later on it will be sent to the production department, where the production will be carried out. And after the product is developed and manufactured, it will be sent to the quality control department, where they will, the engineers will check by using some instruments. They will see whether the component is made as per the given specifications or not. They will check, and after that it will be sent to the market. Okay, this is about product life cycle, where we are not using any computer, but the engineers will solely develop all this by using some conventional machines. Now if you see, what is the role of computers in product cycle? In the operations for design and manufacturing, how computers are being used and what are the areas we are using the computers. Now if you see, here if you see the customers, after getting the requirement or need from the customer, they will develop the product concept. And after developing the product concept, it will be, we use computers for design. In designing engineer, design engineer will use the computer aided design. The computers and the designers both combinedly will develop the drawings. The drafting is made, and computer automated drafting and documentation, where after the computer, by the use of computers, when design engineer will develop the drawings, it will, the computer will automatically do the it will save, store the drawings, and also we can get the documentation, which means we can take the printouts, or we can send that drafting drawings to the manufacturing plant. And after the drawings are made, they will do the process planning, where here also the engineers will use computers to develop process planning, and also they will use computers for scheduling the production, computerized scheduling, MRP.